In this video, you will learn how to use expanded reverse 12 cokes with multiple applications. Hey, I'm Ivan from Expanded, the world's safest platform for doing automated LinkedIn outreach. If you wish to turn your LinkedIn into a lead generation tool, be sure to subscribe for our weekly growth hacking tips and tricks and hit the bell so you won't miss the next episode. Let me ask you a question. What does your LinkedIn outreach funnel look like? Probably a mix of email, ads, LinkedIn, and something else, right? Even though there are a ton of lead generation tools out there, it's still difficult to connect everything. But now you can grow your LinkedIn profile automatically with very little effort. This is achieved by using Expandee and its unique set of features that enables you to develop more connections and make your LinkedIn account stand out from the rest. Stay tuned if you want to know more about the campaign integrations using Expandee reverse webhooks in a simple step-by-step guide. Let's dive into it right away. Hi guys, so now we're going to take a look at the technical part of the reverse webhooks. Inside of the pre-made campaign, which I named Reverse Messenger, we go to integration tab. And you can see there are three different URLs. For assigning people by using webhook, you can use this simply URL for your current automation flow in order to assign the people to your connector or messenger campaign, in our case messenger, with a specific payload. In that payload, the only mandatory thing is the profile link, which needs to be existing as a parameter. With the other action URLs for pausing and continuing a specific prospect inside of the campaign, all you need to do is call those from a third-party system or a web browser, whatever you prefer, because the only thing you need to do here is campaign contact ID, which you can find inside of the body of the reverse webhook of the person, so to say. So I know many of you are doing meetings and mainly using Calendly. So now I'm going to show you how to integrate Calendly with Zapier and to put the contact to follow him afterwards in your expanding campaign. So how we're going to do that? First of all, you need to go to Calendly and have your own sessions. As you may see in my profile, I'm currently having two types of sessions. One of them is experience exchange and expanding session. For the purpose of the video, I'm going to use that one. So make sure that when you have invited questions to set up mandatory fields that they need to fulfill when they're signing up. And as you remember, the URL, it's definitely mandatory for the payload inside of Expandee. So that's why we are having it here. A colleague of mine have already been signing up throughout this form for the test purpose. So I'm going to use her data when we go to Zapier. So now let's switch to Zapier thingy. First, you need to choose where to integrate. So choose the application Calendly and invitee created. So this is when somebody is simply signing up, choose the correct account by verifying here. I already set it up to my own, and you can test the trigger at the end to work successfully or not. But as you can see, that's her data, so everything works out. This condition is like continue only if. Actually, it's like filtering by Zapier, and it needs to filter on a specific event. And why I'm doing this? Because as you saw in my Calendly, I had a couple of sessions. So I want only from a specific session to come people to that specific campaign, so the message can be personalized and I know who I'm following up. That's why I filter on event type, starts with, and name it Expandee Sessions, because that's how I named inside of Calendly. Then we have to choose a post request and choose choose webhooks by Zapier, post event type. And then all you need to do in the setup actions is actually copy the URL from the campaign that you are having here, which is this one. So you just copy it and go again to Zapier and you replace it with that value here, which I already did. So once you're done, you need to select the payload to be JSON and put all the fields that you want. And the profile link actually is the mandatory one. The rest you can skip, but that's actually the mandatory one. And set a wrap request in the array to be no, and also unflatted yes. That's all. And once you go here, you can simply retest the action. And if everything works out, when we go to people, you see I already have a contact here, so I can follow him with a nice message. Pretty much that's how you can use the reverse webhooks with integration with Calendly. And also don't forget, you also have those two action URLs for pausing or continuing a specific person afterwards. As I already explained, you can access it from another system or web browser by simply copying this, replacing the campaign contact ID, and you can just simply paste it in the browser if you want to test it out, if it works out.
So that's all. Hey guys, so now let's look more into the technical part of the reversed webhooks. First of all, where to find them. If we go to the campaigns, in each campaign, you would see that there is an integration tab. So pretty much here, there are separate links. Each of them is for a specific purpose. Of course, if you want to outreach a specific client, let's say directly from outside of the expanding, you can use those URL, which pretty much help you to integrate the current automation flow and assign people to a connector or messaging campaign by using the URL with the particular payload. So in that, the profile link is mandatory for the payload that you're going to send to the system. And those are optional fields. If you prefer, you can use them as a parameters and the system will recognize them as a placeholder, so to say. And also you would see that we also have those two other URLs in order to pause or continue a certain contact directly from the system. So with those URLs, you can pretty much easily resume or continue a contact by calling the URL from another web system or CRM system if you have integrated properly with Zapier. Of course, probably you're asking, okay, what is this campaign contact ID? It's very simple. You can easily find that information, for instance, when you select a certain webhook here and just go step by step, you'd be able to see this inside of the campaign instance contact. You'd see the ID, and here there is all the data. So once you have exported the contact, you'd have those URLs, so you can easily paste them and play around with them, save them. So wherever you have some contact, you can just simply call that. Just for the test purpose, I would simply just paste it in another tab, and bam, it will call it like directly whether the contact was paused or resumed.
In our next video, we'll be dropping many more super cool tips and tricks. You can always trust to get a lot more leads and connections on LinkedIn. So see you soon.